Today, we will continue with the chapter Parts of a Plant. In our previous classes, we had studied about roots, type of roots, and different parts of a plant. So now in today's class, we are going to study about stem. Students, you all know that this whole part of the plant, which is above the ground, this is a shoot. Now, this main part of the shoot, this is the stem. So stem is the main part of the shoot. See these two plants also. See, this is the stem of this plant. This is the stem of this plant. Now I ask you a question. Is the stem of all these three plants similar or different? It is visible, yes, it is different. See, here the stem is strong. Here the stem is not so strong, it is weak. And in this plant also the stem is weak. And in this plant the stem is so weak that this plant could not stand upright. It needs support. If I want to make it upright, I have to give the support of hand, or I can give the support of some stick or scale. Okay, so different plants have different type of stems. So the plant which has strong stem, they are called trees, and the plant which have weak stem, they are called herbs. And the plants which have weak stem and they need support to stand upright, they are known as climbers. See, this is a money plant. It is a climber. In the same way, you must have seen grapevine. Okay, that is also a climber. So now let's try to understand the function of the stem. What is the function of the stem? See, if the stem would not be there, okay, if I take out the stem, where will all these leaves, branches, buds and flowers will go? They will fly in the air. Yes. So, you may have guessed, what is the function of the stem? The function of the stem is to support the plant and hold the leaves, flowers and buds. Now, see students, I am watering the plant. Where is this water going? In the soil, and from the soil, it will be absorbed by the roots. This I have already shown in my previous video also. Okay, now the water is absorbed by the roots, but the water is needed by the leaves to make the food. Now how will the water from the roots reach all these leaves? Yes, can you guess? Yes, see, the roots will absorb the water, and from the roots the water will be absorbed by the stem. Now the stem will transport the water to all the leaves. Okay, it will transport the water to all the leaves. So the second function of the stem is to conduct water and minerals to the leaves.
What are you doing, Mama?
Beta, I am chopping vegetables for preparing food. You know, food is very much important for us. If we don't eat food, then how will we get energy? Food is very much important for us to get the energy. Plants are also living, so they also need food for themselves. As I have to cook food, where would I go to cook my food? In the kitchen. So plants also need kitchen for preparing their food. Would you see any kitchen here? No. Okay, I'll tell you. See, these leaves. Plants prepare their food in the leaves. So, leaf is the kitchen of the plant. Now, if I have to cook food, I need some material for cooking food. Like just now, I was cutting vegetables for cooking my food. In the same way, plants also need material to cook their food. They need four things to make their food. First one is water. Second is sunlight. third is carbon dioxide, and the fourth is chlorophyll. Now these four things, from where do plant get all these four things? First is water, that you know, we water the plants and the we water the plants in the soil, so and the roots absorb the water. Now second is the sunlight. From where does the plant get sunlight? It is very clear, from the sun. Sunlight is absorbed by the leaves directly from the sun. Third is carbon dioxide. Now as we breathe, we take in oxygen and give out carbon dioxide, and this carbon dioxide which we give out in the atmosphere, it is absorbed by the leaves. And the fourth thing is chlorophyll. Now see students, these leaves are green in color. Do you know why these leaves are green? It is due to the presence of chlorophyll. In these leaves, a substance is present which is green in color, and that substance is known as chlorophyll. So the four things which the plant needs to prepare their food are water, sunlight, carbon dioxide and chlorophyll. And the process of making food by the green plants is known as photosynthesis. So this whole process by which the plants make their food with the help of water, carbon dioxide, sun and chlorophyll is known as photosynthesis. Now this word photosynthesis is made up of two words, photo and synthesis. Photo means light and synthesis means mixing together. Okay, so photo means light and synthesis means mixing together. Okay, food which is prepared by the plant, it is stored in different parts of the plant in the form of starch or sugar, because at a time plants cannot consume all the food, so they need storage. So they store the food in the form of sugar and starch.